Welcome to Damn Good Movie Memories with your host, Brian Davis. This podcast is the cure for your long commute and super boring workday. Hey there, it's Brian Davis, and for this week's episode, we're going to wrap up the three-part series. It's almost like a mini-series of our celebrity sightings. I'm all out of celebrity sightings, so don't worry about it. This has been a crazy week. Not that anybody really cares, but I've been on jury duty for the past week, and now I'm officially on the jury in the middle of a trial. So we'll see what happens next week. I do have interviews stored, so we'll probably broadcast something. What I should do is probably do a review of The Runaway Jury. I think that would be smart. Or any John Grisham movie, which I all love. Anyway, so not much of an intro this week, but let's enjoy what everyone else has to say about their celebrity sightings, and we will talk to you next week. Okay, where's the laugh?
Not gonna laugh.
Oh, now she's not gonna laugh.
No.
I don't believe you.
It's not.
Yeah, there you go. That was a record. That took about 6 seconds.
Hey.
All right. For this week's episode, this is going to be interesting. So we're going to talk to you and Danielle about your favorite, or not favorite, but your celebrity encounters. My guess is most of them were in Brazil.
Yes.
And as I'm discussing this with her, she's like, oh, I remember I did meet someone in the U.S. And who was that?
Oh, Mickey Mouse.
Yeah, she met... She met Mickey
Mouse. And Mary Poppins.
And Mary Poppins. So I had to break the news, and I said, that's fair. You can talk about that. Unfortunately, it was a stuffed animal.
Oh, no, it was a real person.
Real Mary Poppins, yes. Okay, but besides those celebrity encounters, which were amazing, I'm sure, did Mickey talk to you?
Yes.
He's not supposed to talk. You're not supposed to talk in those things.
Mary Poppins.
Get off my foot, lady. Yeah.
Shut up.
Okay, let's talk about your real celebrity encounters.
Okay. So, well, I had a bunch in Brazil, but you guys don't know,
matter. No, but you can explain who they're.
So, I'm from Rio,
okay.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And in Rio is where most of the celebrities live.
Okay.
And especially the place where I live.
Mm-hmm.
And I would see, like, all the soap opera people, actors and actresses. It was super cool. Like,
yeah.
We'd go to the supermarket and see this person. And since they live in the neighborhood, no one cares, right?
They're just normal people?
No, yeah.
Yeah.
But especially the women without the makeup, you look and is it her? Maybe. You look and you look at it again, but it's funny. But for the guys, it's easier.
Okay.
So there's this, we have our Al Pacinos and, all the bum 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 guys and women. And I saw one once. I was in a bar with friends, and I was leaving. It's like a cafe bar. They had it's a bookstore and a CD store, and they had these bossa nova famous people who go there just to sing a little one or two music.
Mm-hmm.
They not get paid for that. They're drinking there, and they just like start singing. And then I saw this guy that was really a fan of him,
mm-hmm.
and he is super tall. He's like. He's super old too, but he was very like, here would be like Sean Connery, something like
Got
that.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, I was like, oh, it's him, it's him, he's super tall. And I went, oh, I'm super, I really like him. And I was like 18, and
yeah.
The guy was like 60 years
right.
old. And he was like, really? And I was, yeah.
It's not the type of music that...
No, not music. He's an actor.
He's an actor.
Yeah,
okay.
So it was super cool. Like, he was in the same bar that I was.
Yeah.
And
so was he nice?
Yeah, super nice.
Yeah.
We know, I've seen, like, the soccer players.
Sure.
You know, like, Ronaldinho, that you guys know.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, Ronaldinho Gaúcho,
mm-hmm.
Romário. We have, like, Dunga. Dunga is the captain. No, not the captain, the trainer. I don't know.
Okay.
From the Brazilian team.
Yeah.
Soccer.
The national team.
Yeah. So, I saw all those in the beach because we have... We play volley by the beach. It's
mm-hmm.
super normal in Copacabana or in Barra da Tijuca. And we have a sport there called futebol.
Okay.
That is like volleyball mixed with soccer.
How do you play that?
So you do the movement. I'm like swinging my feet around. Yeah. I love that game. Yeah. Because you play like regular volleyball, right? But you don't need to dive on the sand if you don't want. You just
kick the ball.
You know, like you just play like that. It's super popular in Brazil, actually.
But it's not an official sport? Like they don't have teams?
I don't think so.
So it's like a beach game?
Yes.
Okay.
So they would be there because they're all friends, mm-hmm. and Romário, who is very, like, he was in the World Cup when we won in 94. So all those players from 94, they're very good friends.
Got it.
And I would see them almost every day by the beach, super cool.
Yeah.
And we had these kids, how do you say, not host. She had a TV show and for kids.
Okay.
And she was like Michael Jackson style. She would like be very recluse in her house. She has a pink house. It was like that crazy where you have like followers and, you know, people sleeping at her door. It was insane. And I went to her show a few times. And she had those little girls who would help her.
How old were you? How old were you?
That was like 7, 8 years old.
Okay.
But I would go to the show.
So it was like the Mickey Mouse Club almost type of?
Almost.
Like Miley Cyrus?
Yeah, I'll show you the picture.
Okay.
So she was blonde and she has the 7 helpers, all blonde, long hair.
7 helpers.
Yeah, no, I'm not kidding. So all the girls were like...
So were they dwarfs?
No.
She wasn't Snow White?
Beautiful girls.
Okay.
Like... So 10 to 15, because they had to keep the kids, the little kids away, and my mom tried to... people would go crazy for the... What's the name of the person? The host is not host. Anyway.
The actress?
So, the presenter? Is it?
Sounds good to me. Yeah.
So, yeah. So my mom tried to make me
one of the girls. One of the dwarfs.
So it was not a dwarf.
One of the followers.
So it was funny because at the time we didn't have digital pictures, right?
Sure.
You could not see how the picture was. So my mom would take the pictures.
She wouldn't take Polaroids? Did they have Polaroids?
Yeah, but they didn't accept Polaroids. They need like regular Kodak, etc. So all the 12 pose was so serious because I don't like being in the spotlight like that.
Okay.
So my mom would say, smile. And they would smile, but she would go, behind the camera and she didn't see that. I was like, make your face. And she was so mad. She could not enroll me. Anyway, so yeah, that.
But you didn't really want to do that, did you?
Never. But. Never.
So your mom was like a stage mom.
So my mom, because she was kind, not a celebrity, but she was in TV
She was
a model for Dulore. Dulore is like Victoria's Secrets for United States. They have the shows. They use it to have the shows.
Right.
The runway shows. So she was a runway model for lingerie. And she was a dance stage for a TV show.
Okay.
A very famous TV show. And
there's no video of this anymore?
Thank God, no. So she loved that.
Sure.
And she wanted me to do it. So I did modeling when I was from 6 to 12.
Mm-hmm.
I did runway modeling.
Really, that long?
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, I was 4, so I was 6. Who would say no for my mom? And we got the clothes.
But you hated doing that?
I didn't like it. Well, I remember 6, 7, 8, I was okay. But then you go to media school and people, look at you, you know, on the picture, on your, like, on the store.
Yeah.
There, it's not a good feeling. Yeah. And my body started changing too, so it was too much for me.
Sure.
So I
gave up. Went completely polar opposite and you went into physics.
What?
You went into physics in school and everything. Like, you did not want to be a model.
No, not at all. Yeah. I cannot be a model. I'm not that tall or gorgeous. But as a kid, it's easy. Like, any kid can be a model. You know?
Any kid.
You need to do, like, be little cute. Okay, go.
Little cute.
It doesn't matter.
Got it.
So, yes. From here, I have a friend who works for the 49ers, and every year, and I have a friend who is a breast cancer survivor.
Mm-hmm.
So every year, the 49ers do this event for the Breast Cancer Association, the Susan something.
Susan Komen?
The Pink Ribbon.
Yep.
So they have this event that takes, it's a day, that you pamper or yourself. Mm-hmm. It's like they have manicure and makeup, hair. They give you a lot of stuff. And who is, I mean, my friend, we are all friends. So my friend who works for 49ers, the friend who had breast cancer, me, we're friends. We're all mutual friends. So I go as a guest, right? Mm-hmm. And there's all these commercials thing that it passed when the game is starting between.
Yeah.
Are you trying to cut me?
No.
So that's so...
I'm making sure
I'm talking as fast as I can.
No, I'm making sure...
And I have
sure
an accent.
If I don't do that, then I miss out. Like, it goes to sleep, the computer.
Okay.
Thank you for ruining
the
illusion.
Am I boring the
computer? Yes, the laptop's falling. Yeah, he's falling asleep. So let's move along here.
So anyway, so yeah, so we go to this 49ers. I did twice. And they do this commercial thing.
What sport do the 49ers play?
Isn't football?
Very good.
Okay,
all right.
The football that you play.
The
hands.
That's
but,
right.
Okay.
That
the handball. But okay. Anyway, so this is a huge event, actually. They close. It was AT&T thing. No, not AT&T.
Levi's Stadium.
Levi's Stadium.
That's where the San Francisco 49ers play.
Yes.
In Santa Clara.
So, so we go there, spend the day, and there's the game. And before this game, all these players comes, you know, to talk with us. And they're all around all the time. So I'm sure they are celebrities.
Are they wearing their shoulder pads and everything?
Yes.
Really? They're
no, they have the union because they're going to play after.
Oh, okay.
So so it's funny because I don't know them.
Sure.
So I talk. But I don't know them.
Because they don't mean
anything. So then my friend comes, oh, he's this player. It's like...
I don't care.
Doesn't matter to me.
So it'd be like if I was talking to a Brazilian soccer player, it wouldn't mean anything to me.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. So it's fun. It's a fun thing. So
unless I was talking to Pele. I would know who Pele is.
Pele, yes.
He's from Brazil, right?
Really?
I don't know. That'd be like, okay, what? Do you know who Joe Montana is?
I heard.
You've heard. Well, it's the same thing.
See, I've heard about him.
Same
is
difference.
He American?
He is American. He's the greatest American of all time, Joe Montana.
For what? For what?
Because he was a...
What sport?
San Francisco 49er. He played football.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
See, I don't know.
Yeah.
So...
there you go.
So, yeah. So, the 49ers thing is cool.
Mm-hmm. Though you have no idea who you're talking to.
No.
You just know they're very large and...
I know. Yeah. So, even like when we did a fundraiser for my friend, we got donations from the 49ers because... You know, through my other friend who works there. So we got valuable items. We got like
the memorabilia.
Like, you know, the shoes signed by them, shirts signed
the
by
helmets.
Them, helmets. So we could do a silent auction.
Yeah, auction. Yeah.
Yes. I had no idea I had all this valuable stuff.
Oh, yeah.
I just like put in my car and I drove around, you know, like leave out. I had to do my groceries. I had to do stuff. And it was open. Like,
probably
on
thousands
my car.
Of dollars worth of memorabilia. In
it
there.
Was open on my car. Like,
oh,
I didn't even
God.
Put in a bag and everything. I signed and, you know, we had tickets, good tickets, like front row tickets for the game. I had no idea. So that. So when I told my friend, I was like, oh my God, did you laugh?
Yeah. So you do this every year?
And what?
You go to this auction?
For this? No. The auction was me. I organized the fundraisers. So my friend made this donation.
That's
I had
great.
Photographers. I have each person I knew, I asked to something that they could give.
That's really cool.
Yes. See, I'm a celebrity too. I can
there you go. Who knew?
We raised $10,000.
That's awesome.
So, almost 10,000.
Mm-hmm.
So, I met those players too.
Mm-hmm.
It's real game. It's not like the non-famous players. It's real players.
I know.
So they're celebrity. They count, right?
Of course. You couldn't. Unfortunately, you can't name one of them, but that's fine.
I cannot name.
I won't make
it's
you
terrible.
Try.
So, yeah, every year this happens. I don't go every year, but I went twice, and it's super cool.
Well, don't forget your favorite podcast host, because maybe we can have him on the podcast.
I know. So, yeah, when we have, like, Brazilian singers visiting here for shows, I get tickets, like, from my other friend. I have good friends, Rosie.
Yeah. I know you're very connected.
She is the one who brings them.
Sure.
How do you call it? There's... So she has
She hosts them?
No, she has these agents and she invites them to come to her. So I get tickets from her and I get backstage.
Nice.
Fast. So, well, me and a bunch of people, not only me, I'm not that special.
Too bad you didn't get them for Bon Jovi.
No, Brazilian people.
I know.
I had this singer that I am in love with him. And he was like my first love. I'm not kidding. And I love him. I still love him. So I went to his show and I went backstage and I saw crying.
Did you really?
And I was like, why are you crying? And I was so embarrassed. I didn't care. I saw crying and I hugged him. He was so sweet, so nice. I remember as a kid, I wanted to marry him.
How old is he?
Very old.
Aww.
Very old. Yeah. Like 60, 70 years old. But he's a composer and the singer, so he sings his own song.
And he's probably telling all his friends, this crazy lady is crying at my show. But
he's super, he's like a poet. His songs are beautiful, you know, it's so meaningful. And he's from a time in Brazil, like he started that Brazil is going through a very difficult phase. So all these singers that start on that time, they still singing together. It's really good. So, yeah, he hugged me and he gave me a rose and
nice.
It was super sweet. Mm-hmm. Yes. And I almost went for lunch the next day. Yes, we took a picture.
Good.
And but now everything is digital. I don't know where's my picture. It's one of my...
one of your greatest
It's like things? On Amazon because we have the thing that backups our computer.
The cloud, yeah.
On Amazon, so it's probably there.
Good. Okay, so do you have any other celebrity encounters?
I do.
Okay.
You're going to look at the time again.
No, it has nothing to do with the time. It has to do with, I have to make sure that, whatever, you're wasting time here.
So, no, I don't know if I do or not, but one day I was, long time ago, Clara was my daughter, who is 11 now. She was like under a year old. I just like got here at the time, and I was walking in Menlo Park, and I was going to do my grocery shop. And this guy came running. He was jogging.
Mm-hmm.
And I look at him, and he looked just like Sheldon from The Big Bang Theory.
Oh, yeah.
And I love Big Bang Theory, and I love Sheldon.
Mm-hmm.
He's always wrong on that. Physicists are not that arrogant, but I love him. So I started looking at him like, is it him or not? You know, like, oh, maybe isn't. But he looked at me and he did the face, the Sheldon face.
So Jim Parsons, the actor.
I don't know his name. And it was like, I was, you know, pushing the stroller. I was like, it's him. Oh, maybe he just looks like him and he does the impersonation. Mm-hmm. I don't know if it was him or not.
So you didn't say anything to him?
No.
You didn't cry in front of him and then give him a hug?
No. I had my baby with me. No.
She said, she's your biggest fan.
I know, I should, yes. But yes, like, here I just have the 49ers and maybe this one.
Yeah.
And
that's a good one. Those are good. Okay, so the secondary question we've been asking people are who is the celebrity that people have said you look like?
So I don't think I look like any celebrity, but...
I'm saying, who do people think you look like?
So, no. Yeah. I don't know. So some of my friends say that my personality is very similar to Rachel from Friends.
So that's Jennifer
they
Aniston.
Think they, yeah, some say, oh, you look like Jennifer Aniston. I don't think so.
She's definitely the hair.
Very pretty. I don't think I look like her. But the personality from Rachel, I do think I have a little bit because I am so like, all over the place.
I can't tell from this interview. Yeah.
I'm so over the place and, you know, I'm like bubbly and stuff. So I can see the personality thing going on, not the look. So
I think your hair is exactly like Jennifer Aniston.
Oh, thank you.
Yes.
Very well treated.
Well treated hair.
And we always tend, so
there you go. So, right. So
that's all you need.
So that's
to be
only
a twin.
So nobody's and nobody said anybody else, or is it all Brazilian?
It's all Brazilian. There's a lot of Brazilian like actress that people
Just
say
think
I
you look
like.
Yeah, but no Americans.
I don't think I look like anybody. I'm unique.
That is definitely
like
true.
Like everybody else.
Yeah. Well. You could have been famous. You could have been one of the little followers of that TV show, but that didn't pan out.
Thank
That's okay.
You.
Instead, you're famous on this podcast. So.
Yay!
Good job, Danielle. Thank you.
Okay, we're back with Lynlea, and then see, I'm talking loud now. So
that's your radio voice.
That's right. We talked about it last week. I turn it on like
you have
normally.
A radio voice.
Normally, yeah. I'm just
I need
boring.
To work on my radio voice.
No, your radio voice is fine. You just have to get closer to the mic. That's all. No, no. She's all self-conscious. You just, like, there's nothing here. We're just having a conversation. So, speaking of getting nervous and seeing celebrities, what are your encounters with celebrities over the years?
I don't have a lot.
Okay.
And I have a really lame one. MC Hammer.
No way. Where was that at? Was he
so
Hammer
he
or was he
up,
MC Hammer?
No, I have two specific incidents with MC Hammer. No, yeah, it was in the 80s when he was in his heyday. He actually lived in my hometown in Fremont,
That's
California.
Right. Yeah.
So Fremont was this bedroom community before, like early 80s to mid 80s, they started mansions and McMansions, like wealthy homes up in the hills. But it was really a working class bedroom community of San Francisco.
Mm-hmm.
MC Hammer was kind of unknown the first interaction I had with him, which it wasn't really an interaction. His nephew came to live with him and his wife and his children from Georgia. Like he was taking care of his nephew, and his nephew went to high school with me.
Mm.
My friend Inger Leonard, if you're listening, Inger, hi. she had a crush on Nathan or wanted Nathan to go to prom with her. But anyway, I would then offer to give Nathan and her a ride home to MC Hammer's apartment.
Nice.
And this was before he was super famous, but he was kind of a well-known local rapper, I guess, but lived in kind of a shitty, whatever, a two-bedroom suburb apartment.
He got big. He worked for the Oakland A's.
Yeah.
He was like the bat boy and kind of Charlie
Finley's
guy.
He's from Oakland.
Yeah.
So he then moved. And then he did eventually, like after the big, one-hit wonder, right? He was a one-hit wonder.
Had two good albums. So like, Hammer Don't Hurt Him and then
something like that.
Too Legit to
know.
Quit was kind
and,
of
Yeah,
like,
anyway, he would tool around in his convertible Mercedes, a convertible BMW in like his very like tweed shoulder padded jacket.
Yep.
He was pretty obvious. And he even, I think, had his license plate said like Hammer Time. So he was very recognizable.
Right.
So,
which is why he probably went broke with all this stuff.
He did go broke.
And
he went
entourage.
Bankrupt and had to move to Modesto
at some point
a few years after that.
Oh,
he did go broke.
Yes.
So anyway, in this car, we pull up. My mom is driving. Pull up behind him, and I was like, oh, that's MC Hammer. My mom beeps, beep, beep, and waves. And I was like, oh, my God, Mom, I'm so embarrassed. And he waves back.
Yeah.
He's totally nice. And she was like, what? Who's MC Hammer?
She was just like,
oh, my. I mean, it's pretty, like, he's very distinctive looking in this car, so.
Does he look like one of my peers, Mom?
Yeah, it's like my buddy, MC Hammer. So anyway, that was my only.
So what was the other encounter?
Just driving
to his house.
Yeah, just driving to his house.
That's fun.
That was not really an encounter. That was just his nephew. I thought he was nice. He was like a nice guy. He was actually, taking care, like moving him to a better school district.
Yeah.
This nephew, taking care of the nephew and raising his family. He had young children.
Yeah.
And then Nathan, and he was really strict. I think actually he couldn't go to prom with Inger because he got like a C on his report card or something.
Yeah.
I thought it was something like he was pretty strict with him too. So it was kind of cute.
I've only heard good things about him. Like people that I've encountered me, and actually it probably led to his going bankrupt because he was giving all of his buddies
money. I think that was one of the stories on the Where Are They Now?
Yeah.
Or I don't know.
Yeah.
Super lame.
It's really hard for athletes and musicians who grew up in like, poor neighborhoods and their buddies are all kind of like hangers on, it's tough.
And I think he's a little religious or somehow connected to
a church.
I think
he is too.
I'm not really sure. Something like that. Anyway, that's my encounter.
That's a good one.
Not really exciting.
No, I like that one. That one's good. Okay, so with the others.
Oh, the other one is just my only two A-lister sighting was, and I was with Stephanie, so Stephanie could also tell this story, and also Richard Stoffager.
Oh, yeah,
who used
from New York. Yep.
We were in New York having brunch and we're waiting in brunch, you have like a sign in list.
Yeah.
I had to wait an hour, like that's kind of like a typical New York brunch experience at a hot restaurant. And
what was the restaurant?
Prune.
Okay.
It's well known
for
brunches, and it's been featured on like an Anthony Bourdain show too.
Oh, cool.
I mean, this was something before that, I think. Anyway.
Yeah.
It was Reese Witherspoon and Jake Gyllenhaal were there. They just really signed in. They were waiting for their brunch like the rest of us. Like, you'd think they could just walk in and get a table. And it was when they were dating in Super A-List. So, I don't know if this is, like, circa 2010, maybe? 2009?
That sounds about right.
It's just that's before she remarried and had children.
So, it was after she broke up with... God, what's his name? She had a kid with him.
Ryan Felipe.
Ryan Felipe, yeah.
Yeah, she has two kids with them. The daughter looks exactly like her. So they were just there hanging out, walking down the street. They looked really tiny mm-hmm. in person, but it was very distinct of them. And then what was funny is that nobody paid attention to them at all. You know, everybody played it cool, even though we all knew exactly who it was. But the second they got right, and then people looked at their cell phones and took pictures of them, took a bunch of pictures of them. So I couldn't do that. That was not,
Did you get your flip phone to take a picture?
I probably had a flip phone. No, I think I had an iPhone, but barely,
It's funny. I just saw Jake Gyllenhaal as a kid in City Slickers. He plays Billy Crystal's son.
I would think he's even too young for that. Like, City Slickers came out so long ago.
1990. So
I don't know how old he is.
He's probably in his, mid-30s?
Is he in his mid-30s? Okay. Yeah. I have no concept of how old he is.
Yeah.
Someone said before Donnie Darko, they knew him. They were friends with him. And I know his parents are movie producers or something, right?
His sister's also an actor.
They told a story. Some other B-list actor was telling a story about being friends with Jake Gyllenhaal, but that he was just like the hottest, most popular, like the guy you just envied, like everybody swarmed to him, like he just had that charisma or something before he was even famous, before he was even acting. I guess he was acting in City Slickers, so he was in things.
At first I was like, I think that's him, and then I just kind of ignored until the movie's over, and then I saw his name on the credits. So that was
Weird. His parents are in the movie industry, that writers or directors or producers. Mm-hmm. I don't know, something like that.
So any other B-listers, or do you have B or C-listers?
Jonathan Pryce was the other most exciting
one.
I followed down the streets of London.
And
he gave me, I can't, it's on radio, so he gave me this. I'm looking over my shoulder and like giving this side eye because I was. Yeah, I was following him for several streets.
Are you obvious about it? What did you want an autograph, or did you want...
No, I wasn't going to say anything. I just wanted to follow. I was with my husband, who actually, I think it was before we were even married, but he's the one who said, like, oh my God, that's Jonathan Pryce. He was really right next to us, and I was like, let's follow him. And so we did for a while, and then, I gave up.
He's a good character actor. He's in a lot of things.
So. I mean, I love Brazil. That's one of my favorite movies. So.
I think
Have
he's
you
also
ever said that? Brazil is one of my favorite movies.
I think you were in Malin.
Information Retrieval. Yeah.
He was in Jumpin' Jack Flash with Whoopi Goldberg.
I would never know that.
I think he's Jack. So, I think.
I was probably a bigger character actor in the 80s and early 90s. And I don't know what he's been in lately. He was the bad guy in something.
Yeah.
Like a Sylvester Stallone.
You're right,
Or a...
We're going to have to go back. I don't have my phone.
Or a Bruce Willis movie.
It could have been...
not Die Hard. Maybe Die Hard 2 or something. I don't know. A Die Hard type of movie. Or Lethal Weapon or something like that.
Yahoo, the cast of Community. So
you
took a picture.
Also, I'm not comfortable in these meet and greets. I'm also not comfortable with celebrities. So I think I did two rounds of pictures where we waited and got selfies with them, with Joel McHale.
Yeah.
And Joel McHale, I don't take selfies. So I was holding it up, but I had the thing wrong. And I was like, what's wrong with you? Are you drunk? And then he just took the camera away from me and took like 1,000. It's probably still on my camera. Took like 1,000 pictures of us, which was really funny. And then the other guy, Danny Pudi.
Yeah.
And then by the time I got to Gillian Jacobs, I was just too embarrassed and like, oh God, this is too uncomfortable. So I just said, oh, I loved you in Girls. I said I like turn Girls and Community and blah.
I think it's probably easier there because they're already on, like they know they're going to be meeting people.
They were super nice. They were not. And also Dan Harmon was there. Were you?
I didn't go.
Amanda.
Yeah.
I was with Amanda Rodriguez because she was a huge Community
I think
nerd.
Emily was there,
and so was I. Yeah, I think a lot of people. Well, JC and all of those folks were there, but Amanda and I went early to Earl's to watch them, and they just like the whole like before everybody got in, they were just sitting right outside.
Yeah.
So we then I did a Jonathan Pryce move where I snuck through the Yahoo parking lot. So we tried to casually walk from the basketball courts. Like we went out the parking lot through the basketball courts and tried to kind of walk by the side where they were sitting. Cause just when they had those tables on the side of the gym and stuff, and that's where they were all having their kombucha. They all got kombucha. Yeah, so I was excited to see Dan Harmon too, but I would never go up and tell them how much I...
So you're not an autograph or a picture person.
It just embarrasses me. Yeah, I can't...
Well, you don't want to take a picture anyway, like, even without...
No, I don't want to take a selfie regardless or a picture of me anyway. That's why I literally did not know how to take one, how to flip my phone to take it at that time when I met Joel McHale.
We will never do a video podcast. It'll only be audio. Do not worry.
Oh, God, there's no need. I'm definitely a radio... And my voice sucks too, so I'm not going to ruin you.
That's not true. Everyone loves you. That's the fans that listen.
Look what a praiser you are. Huh? See, you praise.
Well, you are really good.
Praising or not.
Oh, I know, yeah. Side tangent here. But we'll do it quickly. You also met some of the 49ers in their heyday.
I did go. Yes, 1980s. So that was in the 80s. I was 11 or 12. Mm-hmm. It was right after they got that World Series. So what year was that? You'll know the year.
The Super Bowl.
Sorry, the Super Bowl, not the World Series.
When they hit the home run.
That was my only thing, is that I was a big 49ers fan in that period.
Well, everyone
of time,
was.
Which I think
everybody
was.
Yeah.
So I was really influenced. So I think I was 11. But okay. Tell me what year that was.
87? I think you said...
Oh, no, 87.
So you said you met Roger Craig, and you said he was a rookie.
Yes.
So it must have been 1983, I'm guessing.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So perfect. Yeah. Hey, I'm good. I'm like, I got my time right. Yeah, so I was really into Joe Montana. I met them, I mean, I have all their autographs somewhere.
Yeah.
I was just really embarrassed. And
even at 11, you were still embarrassed.
No, I wasn't embarrassed then. It was a little, like, there was some, like, inappropriate attention on my friend and I. Like, we just went on this bus by ourselves to their training camp.
Okay.
So it was the training camp, I think, for the next season.
Like, yeah, they used saying, to be
like,
in... Well, sometimes they were
in
Rockland.
Bay Area.
Was it Rockland or?
It was somewhere in the Bay Area. Like, we went from Fremont to took a bus to a town like.
Because they used to
like Redwood City.
Yes,
or,
they did actually use a train in Redwood City.
Okay,
yeah,
so
and then
I
they moved to
Rockland.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Where's Rockland?
Rockland's up north. Like, it's kind of like the, you know.
How many hours away from here?
Maybe like an hour or so. But we're gonna,
oh, it could have been.
We're getting kicked out. But you did.
Okay. I did meet them. I have their autographs. And it was, it was just like a meet and greet. You got to watch the practice.
Yeah.
And then you could stand in line. I mean, they kind of whipped them out. And Joe Montana, I think we had to chase him down to get his autograph.
Yeah.
And follow him, but it was very weird that we were with them. Anyway, we're going to kick out. Okay,
bye. Very angry person. On that note.
I don't think you can hear me say that, can you?
No.
I said hot bitches.
It actually did pick it up.
I said hot bitches.
It did pick it up, sorry.
I won't edit any of this out.
All right,
so welcome back, guys. We have Jenice.
Yay, hello.
And Sara.
What up?
Well, actually, last time it was Jara, but we're not going
to
do that.
We're going to have to come up with a really good name.
Yeah, seriously.
Jara sounds like the kid that eats paste in class.
Or I bought it at Jared.
Oh, that's right.
Sinise.
Yeah. Sinise.
Oh, that sounds like a system name. Or a band of like SWV or like a 12, the girls, you know, like a, anyway, a
anyway,
90s
yeah.
like trio. But anyway, okay.
Sinise it is. All right, so this week we're going to speaking of famous things.
Yes.
We're going to talk about your celebrity encounters. Now, this could be an actor, this could be a musician, could be an athlete, it could be people that are just famous for being famous.
Yes.
So, I already know you, I've already heard some of these, these
It
picks,
could be somebody who is just famous in their own mind.
Sure.
That's true.
But they're really not that big of a deal.
Right.
But I'm just kidding. So
who wants to start with this one?
I think Janice should start, and I'm going to lock the cat away. Sorry.
Okay, so my celebrity encounter, the most notable one, occurred back when I was 21 years old, still at college at UCLA.
Okay.
I'm taking my 18-year-old friend with her newly minted fake ID to my favorite club in LA. And sweet little thing, she didn't know how to say no to the boys who asked for her number. And mind you, this is pre-cell phone. We're still in pager days.
So she's giving out her pager or landline.
I think she's giving out her landline, I'm pretty sure. And she's just giving it to every guy that asks for it.
It's
one,
a beeper.
Beeper, pager, whatever.
Yeah.
It's not a pager.
I think she's just geeked out that so many guys are asking for her number.
Sure.
And she's too sweet to say no to the ugly guys. So one of these guys will not leave her alone the rest of the night. He keeps coming up to her, and she can't get rid of him. So she asks me to do it for her. And I said, fine. So while I'm gently letting this guy down, letting her know she wasn't interested.
And gently as in, beat it, ugly.
I was actually really nice about it.
You
know, because the guy actually was cool guy. I actually would have been interested in him had he been interested in me.
Right.
Who walks into the club? Dr. Dre.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a club that had all kinds of celebrities. So to me, it wasn't that big a deal that he had walked in there. I think Babyface was in there the week before.
Okay.
And he walks straight up to the guy that I'm talking to. And it turns out this guy is his keyboardist.
Dre has a keyboardist?
Well, like, I mean, when he's laying on tracks in the studio.
I'm thinking Herbie Hancock. Anyway.
Dre comes up to this guy and they're like, hey, buddies, you know, doing their little bro hug, whatever you guys call that thing. And he's just like, hey, I want to introduce you to my friend here. And I meet Dr. Dre, and I'm like, hey, nice to meet you. And that's the end of that.
Mm-hmm.
And I leave the guy alone, and I go tell my girlfriend who was hiding in the bathroom that I got rid of the guy. And by the way, you didn't get to meet Dr. Dre. And she freaks out on me.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, I have to meet Dr. Dre. And I forgot to mention that we had gotten invited to an after party at Dr. Dre's condo.
Sure.
And I had politely turned it down. I'm thinking, what do two college girls need to be doing at a after party for an A-list celebrity?
Right. You're thinking it's going to be way overwhelming, and it's going to be a bunch of, like, hoochies from videos.
And, you know, 100 people, I mean, just lame, basically.
Yeah.
But she begs me to go, so I said, fine, we'll go. You find him, you meet him, and we'll get the hell out of there.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we walk into this condo, and it wasn't so much of an after party. It was, like, let's get high and drunk party.
Right.
So,
just dudes?
No, there was girls there. There were really hot girls there.
Okay. But they were like the music video girls.
Yes, music video girls.
Yeah.
So I said to my friend, hurry up and meet him and let's get out of there. And he was really nice to her and he said hi and end of story.
Yeah.
Yes.
And you were there and
that was
everyone
amazing.
Lived happily ever
yes.
after.
Oh, nice.
But he was a cool guy.
Very cool guy.
Yeah, like
very down to earth.
Yeah.
Yes. You know.
He probably hit on you.
I mean, you know, he was like, hey, I'm Andre, introduced himself as Andre,
right.
So that was kind of cool.
Yeah.
You know, he wasn't, hey, I'm Dr. Dre, which would have probably been lame.
Right. You're like, can I see your PhD, your credentials, doctor?
Yeah.
I don't know
yeah.
about that.
Oh, but the other cool thing about it was
yeah.
I got to hear the Chronic 2001 album before it came out.
That is cool.
Because he was recording it at the time and he was playing the beats at the party.
Yeah.
So I got to hear him before they came out on the radio three,
nice.
4 months later.
Was Eminem there?
That was before Eminem.
Oh, it was pre-Eminem.
No Snoop
yeah.
Dogg, no.
No one else is
so
there.
Yeah, we're gonna do back and forth.
That's
so
funny. Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
So what do I get to tell my story?
Yes.
I didn't even remember my story except for Brian had to remind me of my story.
Well,
that's because I didn't know about it was celebrity in the first place. So it was about 4 years ago. That would have been what, 2013.
Yep.
So it was after work. It was July. I remember because it was hot, and I went to Lenardi's. I'm like, I'm gonna go get something for my lonely single ass, get some fucking soup, and go home. So anyway. I'm walking through the aisles, and there's, like, nobody in there, because it's a July beautiful night, and people are out barbecuing, people who have lives and stuff like that. So, I'm, like, I go into the aisle, and I notice this kid, like,
I love how you call him kid.
Yeah.
Well, he looks like, I like, this, like, 25-year-old kid.
Well,
at
yeah,
the time, he, like, he was young, right?
Yeah,
I
he
thought,
didn't have facial hair.
Wait,
no.
Yeah, let's just wait. So, anyway, but he like, kind of looks at me, and I think nothing of it, really, at first, except for then every aisle that I go down, there he is. And it's not that big of a store. And I was kind of like, huh. And it wasn't until I get to the produce area that I noticed this kid does not look like he knows what he's doing or that he's familiar with the different types of tomatoes at all. Like, he kind of looked, and I'm like, oh, this kid is lingering, like, whatever, right? And I'm like, oh, and he's tall, and he had, like, I remember he had, like, tattoos and
yeah.
a little baseball hat on. I remember gray shorts, red T-shirt, whatever. And I was like, oh, you know, kid. And I could just
sweet
see
smile.
He looks,
yeah,
yeah, he looks kind of
smile.
Like, I can see him, like, looking out the, and seriously, like, every aisle I was on, he was on it. So finally I get to the register, and I look up, and he's right there at the one, and he's, like, kind of looking straight at me. And finally I look at him, and I, like, smile, and that kind of, like, you might want to just, like, try to seal the deal or do something or crash your cart into me or whatever. And, so I leave, I'm walking out, and I go, and I'm sitting in my car, and I realize he gets into the car parked directly bumper to bumper with me.
Okay.
Of course.
And it's like an $80,000 Mercedes. And I'm like, what the fuck? Like, this kid is either borrowed his dad's car,
mm-hmm.
or he's one of the Sharks players or something, because a lot of them live in Los Gatos, and I'm
right.
like, but he looks too tall,
and too black.
Too thin, too... He looked very Italian or, like, Portuguese. No, no, I was there. I'm just telling you.
Okay.
He did not look, I mean, maybe because his hat and he didn't have any facial
maybe,
hair
maybe.
Or anything.
That's probably why, yeah.
So.
He looks totally different.
Right.
Now.
And
oh,
mind
yeah.
you,
yeah.
The audience doesn't know because I haven't yet to say
oh,
his
I
name.
Oh,
I know,
yeah.
So.
We're teasing them, though,
yes.
with little things.
Right,
yeah.
right. Okay, so I'm like, that's got to be, you know. So I have a client who's the dentist for the Sharks. So I text his wife and I'm like, a tall, like, Italian kid with lots of tattoos? I don't think so. Like, he looked too thin, like, too
yeah.
slight.
Right.
And she's like, I don't think so. And I'm like, huh, must be his daddy's car then.
Yeah.
So, whatever. And, like, I'm parked, like, I'm doing something on my phone, and he's, like, sitting there, and I wave at him, and he smiles. And he kind of, like, kind of laughs and whatever, and then I take off. So,
A couple weeks later, I'm at work, and one of the girls is showing me this, like, I don't know, whatever magazine. And I remember, because he had the short sleeve shirt, I remember his tattoos on his arms, whatever.
Yeah.
Right. And so I remember specifically, because I was, a couple times I turned around, I was looking at the back, and remember, whatever. And she shows me this picture, and I go, oh my God, that is exactly the same type of tattoo that this kid at the store, the grocery store the other day, was jocking me. And she goes, like, this tattoo. And I go, yeah. She goes, and she flips through, and she goes, like, and I go, that's the kid that was at the grocery store. Who the fuck is that? She's all, that's Colin Kaepernick. I'm all, who? I go, who's Colin Kaepernick? She's all, blah, blah, blah. I'm all, yeah, I don't even know. I'm all, but he wasn't black. I got the, and then she shows me one, the picture. I think it was a black and white picture. She's all,
no.
Yeah, but it's a facial hair, threw it up, and then it's baseball.
Yeah.
I remember looking at the brim of his hat.
Yeah,
it was straight as hell.
Yeah.
And he started out, I was doing that whole thing, and I was just like, huh. Well, damn. I guess we should have talked to him a little bit. But he doesn't know how to jock people.
Well, I'm impressed that he was walking. He wasn't kneeling.
Right.
He was
doing his own shopping. But then a friend of mine who follows, like, I sent him a message and I was like, hey, well, ask him. He's all, dude, he hates vegetables. I read that in an article once. I'm all, well, clearly, because he didn't know what he was doing in produce. He's like looking around. Well, oh, wait, there was the time that I got asked out by the punter from the, what to call it, the Raiders.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh,
but and Marquette King. But I don't.
Really?
Yeah. But I didn't know who he was either.
He's still their punter.
He sent me a video of him and his dog.
Really?
I still have the video because my friend is a sports agent and I met him and he's like, what's up, Sara? Blah, blah. He sends me and then there's a picture of him and his dog or whatever. And so I text my friend. I'm like, dude, who's Marquette King? And he's all, dude, what's up with you and some athletes? It's a guy friend of mine. He's all, why don't you just get pregnant? That might be more convenient. And I'm like, dude, I'm not a groupie. So I'm just trying to help you out, Sara. Well, thanks.
So, well, that's kind of a drop off. That you went from quarterback to punter,
right?
Yeah.
And I said, "I go, is he really a play for the?" He's off. You call a kicker a player. I'm all right. Whatever.
I just loved how when you were telling me the story years ago, it was like this kid, and it's like when you told me who it was like, did you just refer to Colin Kaepernick as a kid?
He was 20. He was how old is he? He was 25. It was 4 years ago.
I mean, you got him in his prime. I mean, that's when he was.
Well, apparently he didn't have his swagger.
He didn't.
Because
the weird
thing was there was really nobody in there. And other people, I think, knew who he was. Like, looked
well,
like a cashier
yeah.
and whatever. I did not know who he was. Well, then, I mean, there's literally four people in the grocery store, and he hits up every aisle. Maybe he wanted my help. Maybe
well,
he thought, and I see he likes girls that are a little more ethnic. Maybe he thought, I'm like, you know what?
He
probably
does.
Thought,
his girlfriend, he stole her from, whatchamacallit.
Yeah.
I'm thinking that he.
Alden Smith. It was Alden Smith's girlfriend. Stole
right.
it from him.
But clearly I'm not his type. He probably thought I was like his fifth grade teacher from Turlock. He's like, is that Mrs. Bates? I swear to God, that's her. That's why. That's all I got. Do you have another?
What's
yours?
Oh, I already told mine.
Oh.
I have no real celebrity. I mean, definitely not meeting them. Michelle Pfeiffer came to my high school.
Really?
So Dangerous
she
Minds
with...
was about my high school.
Oh, you went to Carlmont?
I went to Carlmont.
Oh, my
oh,
God.
And how did you know that?
Because we used
that's
to play Carlmont.
Yeah.
I went
you
to Aragon.
You two
yeah.
are like... You were like a... After school special.
We, no, we used to be scared when we had to go to their school.
Yes.
Because we're in the Chilean squad. It was like,
yeah.
it was like, it was always in teams. You never went anywhere by yourself on that campus.
Yeah.
I did not know Brian was from the hood.
I'm not. They busting kids from
oh.
the
hood.
So,
the kids from
so
and
back
you
then,
were busting?
No.
Okay,
so I lived
it.
In Belmont.
All right.
But East Palo Alto didn't have a high school, so they bust in kids along
yeah.
the peninsula.
Oh.
So they got bust into either Woodside or Sequoia or... Carlmont.
Yeah, but Carlmont
so,
was the bad one of the three. I mean, it
yeah.
was like, it was the buddy system. You didn't go anywhere alone on that campus. And if it was nighttime,
it was scary, yeah.
at nighttime, then you had to have an adult with you. Like, when we had,
yeah.
a, like, we never had night games there, thank God, but
yeah.
basketball games that
right.
went out till
yep.
10 o'clock at night, it was like, you all walked
so
in the
so they filmed it there, or it was about that? Who was it a book?
So,
it wasn't
was
filmed
it?
There, it was
yeah.
just about that high
so
school.
So the teacher, Luann Johnson,
okay,
that's who Michelle Pfeiffer played, taught there, and she
mm-hmm.
taught the kids that were at risk of flunking out of school.
Right.
So she helped them get an education
okay.
and a degree. She was a Marine. And
right.
so my mom actually worked at Carlmont, and
okay.
so she knew her and everything. And so they adapted the book. I think it was called My Possibility.
Who wrote
to
the
home.
Book?
The teacher.
Okay,
got it.
And then they turned it into a feature film. But they made it a lot more dramatic, and there wasn't gang fights every day. Like, I never
right.
felt unsafe. Now, the year before I went there was during the Rodney King riots.
Right.
That was a problem.
Yeah, that was a little sketch.
There was definitely...
Wait, how old are you?
I'm 38, so I'm almost 39, so yeah.
He's only a year behind me.
I'm the oldest one in this
I
bunch.
Know.
Not by much.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I obviously almost got my cougar pin from Colin Kaepernick.
But anyway, so she came to our high school, we all cut class, and we kind of waved at her
oh,
and,
yeah,
and everything,
cool.
but we never got to, Yes.
But she was hot. She's still kind of hot.
Yeah.
I wouldn't kick her out of
bed. She's very nice. She was nice to everyone that came up to her. And I think so was cool.
That's nice.
Tom Cruise came to the office.
I thought of another one.
Really?
I thought of another one.
With his then wife, Katie Holmes, who towers over him.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He didn't have lifts in his shoes.
Well, she's like 5'9". I think she's like 5'8", 5'9", naturally. And then you tack
on. Is he like 5'5"?
No, he's like, I think he's about 5'7".
I know you guys are all Top Gun whatever fans.
I know you hate Tom Cruise.
We don't hang out anymore. He's just got weird on me.
Mm, I don't care. The man still looks, and he's aged incredibly well. I mean, give him props
because he's a sorcerer weirdo. With
whatever, I'm just saying, he's aged incredibly well. But wait,
okay,
I got one more.
I just remembered
he's gonna have to cut.
So, I am a huge Boyz II Men fan.
And New Kids on the Block.
And New Kids on the Block. Yeah. But
front row, baby!
I actually did get to meet all of them. I even got to hug all of them. And Donnie by far is the best, but that's another story. But no, Boyz II Men. They were doing signings at a Nike Town.
Okay.
That seems really random.
Recently?
No, this was, again, back at UCLA.
Circa 90?
99, 2000.
Okay.
So definitely a big heyday, you know, when they're...
Motown Philly?
No, more like I'll Make Love to You.
Oh,
you know,
baby making music.
Yeah, exactly.
Colin Kaepernick making music.
So I'm with my boyfriend at the time, and he's getting autographs. We're both getting autographs, whatever. And it's like a little line, because there's four of them, so you're going down the line. And so I turn to walk, because I'm in front of my boyfriend, I turn to walk away, and I just asked him, because I asked him the other day on Facebook, did he remember which one it was? And it turned out to the one that it's not in the group anymore, the one that used to walk with the cane, the one with the deep voice, whatever his name was. He told my boyfriend, dude, she's got a nice ass, props. I'm like, why are you getting props on my ass?
Right, I'm the one taking aerobics here, mother.
Yeah, seriously, it's like, why is my boyfriend getting the credit for my ass?
Well, he's just basic. I mean, I'm sure that was good for your boyfriend.
Yeah, that's good. Okay, so back to Sara. You haven't run in, or didn't you? Okay, you're going to tell me the story of their friend, the Peter Gallagher story.
Oh, God, I think you remember better than I do.
It's a good story.
So basically, I have a friend named Peter Gallagher.
He's an agent.
Yeah, he works for, like, you know, a,
like
CAA whatever,
or one of those, you know,
some,
big agencies.
You know, actor or something or whatever.
Yeah.
And when he was kind of like, I don't know what you say, intern, but lower on the totem pole, he would be like the assist, do all this different stuff for, like.
He was the flunky.
Yeah, okay. Whatever that.
Yeah.
So the agents apparently get the official, the invites and the, you know, the actual. For, like, their what's it called? Their clients.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So, there's an actor named Peter Gallagher. He was, like, on the OC. Was it the OC?
He was on the OC.
He's in a lot of stuff. Right. He was in, like, I think some romantic comedy with Sandra Bullock in the 90s.
To Jillian on
her
37th birthday.
Thank you. Okay.
Yeah.
So, ironically, they have the same features. Blue eyes, dark hair. It must be an Irish inbred thing.
Yeah.
While you're sleeping, thank you. So, but there's like a probably, what, like 30-year age difference between them. But, so anyway.
Something like that, yeah.
My friend, being that he was, you know, kind of a crazy party whatever guy, he's like, oh, Peter Gallagher's invitation came. That's funny. I'm Peter Gallagher.
Yeah.
I don't know what the other circumstances or how he thought it would be okay to not actually give it to who it went to. I don't know. Maybe he was shooting one of those movies. So he's dating some girl at the time that he says was a total, like, she was hot, but she was, like, a star humper, like, was all upset, right?
Yeah.
So he's like, I'm going to score with this hot chick. I'm going to bring her to the, was it the Emmys or the Oscars? I don't remember. I think it was the Oscars,
but I could be wrong.
He has the invitation, and he goes, and they actually, like, they check her, and the guy kind of looks at him, and he's like, here's my ID. I'm clearly Peter Gallagher. It says Peter Gallagher.
Yeah.
There's my invite. And so... he gets in, and then, remember he was saying how the chick was like, she was in, look, there's all these faces, and she's like, well, I really wanted to meet Brad Pitt, and he's like, are you serious, bitch? I just brought your low-budget ass to the Oscars, like, those shoes look like they're, like, from last season, and you're gonna be bitching, you can't find the right, he's like, but he was, like, walking around, and did he get caught? I don't remember
him say that now.
Yeah, but he was just like, because you're kind of, you know you're not doing right, but it's like, I'm Peter Gallagher, here's my, you know?
Well, he flaunted it from his boss, because his boss was like standing in like the regular people's line, and he got to go through like the A-list line, flashing his Peter Gallagher badge, and it was just like, his boss was like, are you kidding me
right
now?
Right, he's like, but I mean, I thought it was for me. You could easily say, I thought it was for me. I just love the story about this freaking, well, what kind of spoiled entitled chicks are there in L.A.?
Everything.
Pretty much every one of them, yeah.
Right, I think that's hilarious.
All right, back to Jenice.
I don't know if I've got anything else. Athletes.
But you're a big sports fan.
I am a big sports fan, but have I actually met any?
No, just like 90s pop groups.
And the a famous rapper.
The important shit.
Yes.
I'm just saying.
And a famous rapper who's also a billionaire now.
Yeah.
All right. Well, okay. You know what? Maybe you should have had some babies with them. Like, I should have with the freaking Kickers or whoever they are. Maybe we should have been one of those girls.
Yeah.
I cannot think of one off the top of my head.
Have seen Cuba Gooding Jr. 3 times on 3 different occasions, and I swear a restraining order means nothing to him because he keeps showing up. Twice in Vegas and once in New York. And when I saw him in Vegas one of the times, he was so hammered, like blackout hammered, playing like the nickel slots. And I'm like, Snow Dogs isn't doing so good, huh, buddy?
Was he acting like radio in radio?
No, right. No, he was just like white boy wasted, but he ain't white. And he
is one of those wannabe celebrity kind of stories, okay? So I have a really good friend who's about 6'5", 240, and super black.
Mm-hmm.
So, of course, the average person looks at him and thinks he has to have been a professional athlete.
Sure.
Because if they're that big, they have to have been a pro athlete.
Right.
Yeah.
Just like I had to have been a professional model. Literally.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Oh, geez.
So, he's developed an alter personality that he calls Javon Washington. I won't say
sounds
his real
like
name.
Sounds like a wide receiver to
right,
me.
Right.
I won't say his real name. But anyway, so he's Javon Washington when he goes out in case. In case it happens, especially to meet the gals, you know, just to have fun.
And you know what? They don't even know the name, obviously. So
no,
but
and he always says he used to play for the Toronto Raptors. You know, it's an obscure enough team
right.
that chances are no one here is going to know who played for them 10 years ago.
Oh, I do have another celebrity counter.
Okay.
That no one's going to know from 10 years ago because that's how old he is, that he'd have to have played 10, 15
mm-hmm.
years
right,
ago.
Right.
Okay. So Super Bowl week here, a couple mm-hmm. years ago, we're out in Santana Row, and he's pulling out his Javon Washington thing.
That's pretty good.
There's this guy that I'm checking out, and my friend swears he's into me. I'm like, dude, he's not looking at me. I'm telling you, he's not looking at me. He's like, no, he is. He's totally looking at you. And I'm like, no, I'm not the one he's looking at. And long story short, at some point, my friend goes to the bathroom, and he runs into this guy in the bathroom. He's like, hey, man, you look familiar to me, you know? He's like, oh, well, I played for the Raptors. Hey, man, I played for the, I want to say he played for the Bulls, but he played for somebody.
Oh, shit.
So this guy actually played. No, the guy actually believed him. He was like, oh, yeah, dude, I told him.
Was he a good-looking tall black guy? The other one?
The one that played?
Yeah.
Yeah, but he was really light-skinned.
Yeah.
Really
was his name Copeland?
I have no idea.
All right, just saying.
But he has a white, ugly, fat wife.
No, that wasn't him.
But it was hysterical. Then he was like, oh, yeah, I'm a player with the Toronto. He's like, yeah, that's where I remember you from. And it was just like, wow, so an actual NBA player swears
it worked
he played.
On
yeah.
Him.
Yeah, that's kind of like when I was faking an Irish accent and some Irish people came in and find out where I was. They're like, where are you from? I'm all, ew. Yeah, that's not convenient.
Because you look so Irish. Yeah.
Well, but luckily they're drunk.
That's
really
true.
Drunk.
Yeah,
so.
That's true. Yeah.
But, so I was out to dinner in San Francisco with my friend, the one who is an agent, whatever.
Okay.
There's like 7 people, eight people, big, huge table. And I didn't really know. There were some sweet girls I was talking to. And then some different guys, you know, whatever. And we're all kind of floating around the table. And so this guy comes, and I'm sitting next to this one guy. He's adorable. And anyway, talking to him, this really tall, dark-skinned black guy comes in. And I mean like a tree tall. And he comes in and he goes, introduce himself, super nice, talking blah, blah, blah. He went to college with one of the girls that we're with. And I'm like sitting there, mom, geez, talking, you know, I'm at the end of the table taking these, you know, selfies, getting everybody, whatever. And I'm talking to the guy next to me and I'm like, dude, that kid's tall. You should play basketball. And he looks at me like deadpan. He's all, really? And I'm like, what? And he's all, you're funny. I'm all, does he play basketball? And then he's all, yeah, moron. And I'm like, well, I am not a star fucker. I don't know. And I'm like,
hi, Shaquille O'Neal.
Right. And I finally lean to the girl again. I go, what was his name again? She goes, Festus.
Oh,
and I go, yeah. So I'm like, all right. And I'm telling my friend Wynn, I'm like, yeah, I didn't know. And he's like, well, clearly you don't, because Copeland, you've been talking to for the last hour, played for the Bears.
No.
And he played for Arizona. And but I'm all, he went to Bellarmine. I know that.
Yeah.
I can tell you that much.
Yeah, Festus is like 7'1" or something
like
that.
Yeah, the boy is tall.
He's huge.
Okay, I just remembered one more.
See, this
when
is great.
You said,
this is it, right?
This wasn't, I think I met him. I can't really remember all the particulars, but I had a good friend in college, again, in college at UCLA, because every story is in LA.
God, I should have gone to college.
in LA, too.
Right.
And she was, she interned one summer with the Sparks.
As a trainer.
Okay.
As an intern trainer.
The Sparks is the female basketball team.
Yes.
In LA.
Thank you for me.
And they shared the same practice facility as the Lakers.
Right.
Okay. So she actually knew a lot of the Lakers. And she said she knew Shaq. And sometimes I kind of thought she was bullshitting with some of the people that she knew. Because she always seemed to know somebody. But it was like, whatever, Sheila, you know, Shaq, whatever. So we're in this club one night together, the two of us. And Shaq comes in. Because actually, I think he was part owner of this club in L.A.
Okay.
First off, TV does not do that man justice.
Really?
I think I came up to maybe, I didn't come up to the bicep. I think I came up to about the elbow area of him.
Right.
But his bicep was as big as my head.
Right.
I was just, and I remember just like craning my neck to look all the way up to where he was. And he just leans down to hug my friend. He's like, "What's up, Sheila?" And I'm just like, damn, for once she wasn't bullshitting.
Yeah.
And he's like, I think I met him. I really can't remember, but I just, the impression I remember is that his bicep was as big as my head and that it was like, okay.
Well, he wears, like, a size 20-something shoe,
too.
Oh, wow, there is somebody who wears a bigger size shoe than my dad, then.
There you go.
He's a 16. I thought that was enough.
That
only,
is huge.
Only weirdos that wear
big.
That. Right. My
that
dad's not a big, tall black man. I mean, he's tall enough.
That's true.
Right, but
and he's
true.
Not a clown, either, so that's...
No, exactly. Although, yeah, if you've seen him dance, you might question that a little bit.
Okay, so now we're going to move on to the really fun question, which is, who do people think you look like that's a celebrity? We'll start with Sarah, because Sarah's...
That this is some bullshit because one, I don't look like anyone really. But I years ago when I had like long, it happened to be this one day where I'd put extensions in my hair, and maybe it was around the time where this person had this long, boring, straight hair, and maybe yes, I might have a long horse face as well.
But maybe you're wearing a Canadian shirt.
Maybe, but yeah, this woman was like, "You look like Celine Dion." I was like, okay. And I'm like, what? That's like, okay. I'm all pink. Do you get that a lot? Never. Never. I'm surprised.
I really.
Motherfucking never do.
I don't see it
at all.
Thank you. Do you see anything?
Yes. I.
You do.
With
I think
I do think you look like Gina Gershon.
I actually.
If you pop the lips, maybe.
Maybe it's when he sees me with lipstick. That's why. And
maybe.
I try to look. Yeah.
I see you
he sees me
at
like
work.
Where I've like put effort in sometimes. Yeah. Except for he's probably seen me more hungover than he wants to know about.
Okay.
It's been like 15 years.
My hair
15
still
years.
Ends up okay.
Oh, yeah. There's
only
plenty of times
patches.
I've had to pause and probably go throw up.
Yeah.
But that was when I was young.
Yeah.
Not anymore.
Right.
Yeah. Thank you for the compliment, by the way.
I kind of see it. I kind of see it a little
right,
bit.
Just wait. I'll, you know what? It's because my teeth don't stick out as much as they used to because I don't wear routine eye retainers. She kind of has like her teeth kind of.
Yeah, but it's also.
Yeah, maybe.
In fact, their lips are always doing that weird pouty thing because
it's
too much collagen. So
you both have dark hair. You have the pouty lips.
Yeah, thank you.
So, yeah.
Brown eyes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Bitchy attitude. Maybe.
She kind of always does, yeah.
She
always
has a little
bitch.
Bit. Deep voice. Kind of sounds like a little bit of a rough around the edges.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
What about you?
Well, according to your sister, I look like Adrena Partridge.
Is that her name? Partridge? Partridge?
I thought it was
from
Partridge.
The,
yeah.
The Hills, right?
From The Hills. And
right.
What was the name of that show?
She got her own show.
Yeah.
You're right.
Oh,
she
yeah.
did kind of have the at times. She kind of had that deer in the headlights. I would have slapped my sister. I can't believe she said that to you. She's cute. I'll get that.
Yeah,
right.
I mean, so
I mean,
we're just going.
But did
by
you ever watch
yet.
Her? She'd be like when like Heidi or whoever. She would like oh. She kind of had
no,
that.
She,
like,
yeah, she always looked clueless.
Yeah,
but she thought okay. so.
I
that's
don't,
a nice
I don't
one.
If we're just going facially, then
yeah. Yeah. What does anybody tell you? You look like anybody?
I got David Schwimmer when I was in high school.
I
okay,
but
totally.
That was, and I saw
I totally
like in
that.
People Magazine they had his
right.
high school photo, and
right.
I did kind of look like him.
You're
but that
like,
was a long time ago.
Not enough where you could get into the Oscars.
No, not at all. I don't get Jennifer Aniston. I don't get any of that.
You know, you don't want her. Okay, she's boring.
You hate Jennifer Aniston.
No,
what do you have against Jennifer Aniston?
Because she's boring.
Yeah.
And she only plays Rachel Green in every movie,
yeah.
and it's like
oh,
a waste of time.
Unlike the super talented actress Gina Gershon.
Thank you.
There
she
you
plays
go.
A slut, a lesbian slut,
yeah.
and
a
like
bitchy,
a stripper.
And a bitchy lesbian slut.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
I'm very
She's
talented.
Well-rounded.
I'm very
yeah.
multifaceted.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, see? Another great episode.
Yay!
Thank you, Janice. And Sarah.
What are we called again?
Sinise.
Gary Sinise.
Oh, that's I'm telling you, we sound like a black
yeah.
okay.
Just thank
group.
You,
we'll
Lieutenant Dan.
If you enjoy this podcast and are an iTunes user, please do the show a favor and head on over to the official iTunes page for Damn Good Movie Memories. Be sure to leave a rating and a review. This will allow the show to appear higher in the algorithm and spread the joy of this podcast to the masses. If you are not an iTunes user, you can still listen and subscribe on Podbean at damngoodmoviememories.podbean.com. Be sure to like us on Facebook under our Damn Good Movie Memories page. You can also listen to a limited number of episodes on YouTube. I hope you enjoyed this week's episode, and be sure to tune in next week for an all-new episode of Damn Good Movie Memories.